Morning, my dear students. My name is Dr. K.C. H. Chaparo, working as an associate professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering, Hyderabad. So, in previous class, we discussed the general heat conduction equation in three in slabs, in cylinders, in spheres also. Okay. So, in this class, we'll see the rate of heat transfer, how to find the rate of heat transfer in slabs, first of all. So, heat conduction through slabs or rate of heat transfer in slabs. Okay. So, according to the general heat conduction equation through Cartesian coordinate system, we got this formula. This is the complete formula. So, Kx dou z t by dou x square plus, so ky dou z t by dou y square plus kz dou z t by dou z square plus q equal to rho cp into dou t by dou small t. Okay, so if you take this is the just like steady state condition, this will be zero, because for steady state condition dou t by dou small t equal to zero. So, then if you consider this is the increase in internal energy, so that is zero, then Q will be zero. Then the formula is like this. Okay. So, Kx dou sw t by dou x square plus Ky dou sw t by dou y square. So, plus Kz dou sw t by dou z square. Okay. So, this is the three-dimensional rate of heat transfer problem formula. Okay, if you take the uniform thermal conductivity, then Kx equal to Ky is equal to Kz. So we can take K. Okay, so then if you take the one dimensional flow, either heat transfer according to x direction or in y direction or in z direction. If you take x direction, then Kx dou sw t by dou x square is equal to zero. If you take y direction, dou sw t by dou y square is equal to zero. So if you consider the heat flow in z direction, dou sw t by dou z square equal to zero. Okay, so first of all, you will see the rate of heat transfer in x direction. So, okay, so this is the diagram. Okay, this is a small slab, so rectangular body. The initial temperature is equal to T1, so final temperature is equal to another surface temperature is equal to T2. So, Q shows the rate of heat transfer, how to find that one. Okay, if you take x distance x. So, then at particular distance x, so temperature is equal to T. So, here just initially x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. This is the, L is the length of this slab. Okay. So, at particular distance x, you have to find out the temperature T. First of all, you have to find out the temperature T. So, after that, you have to find out the rate of heat transfer. Okay, so for that you have to consider the just like boundary conditions. Here boundary conditions is equal to at x is equal to 0, so T is equal to, this T is equal to initial temperature T1. So similarly at x is equal to L, so at this length, so then T is equal to T2. So these are the boundary condition. So if you consider this is in x direction flow, then we can take dou sw t by dou x square is equal to zero. So we can take this formula. Okay. So if you integral both sides, then integral here, then this will be dt by dx is equal to constant 2, that is the c. Okay, so if you integrate again this one, so just like, or we can take like this one also, we can shift here. So shift here, dt is equal to, so c1 into x. Okay, or next to integral this one both sides, then integral of this one is equal to t. So integral of x, so that is the c1 x. So with respect to x, we'll get the c1 x. With respect to c1, we'll get the c2. So this is the, just like this one is the general equation. So t is equal to c1 x plus c2. Okay, if you integral 2 times of dou sub t over dou x square is equal to 0, so we will get the general equation. Okay, so then we have to apply these boundary conditions. What is the boundary condition? At x is equal to 0, t is equal to t1. At x is equal to L, t is equal to t2. So if you apply the boundary condition, and you can find out the c1 and c2 constant values, then those c1 and c2 values, if you substitute in the equation 1, general equation 1, then you will get the t value. Okay, we'll see one by one. So this is the diagram. So you know that these are the boundary conditions. So at x is equal to 0, t is equal to t1. At x is equal to L, t is equal to t2. Okay, so this is the general equation. So general equation that came from the dou sub t by dou x square is equal to 0. So okay, first of all, we will apply the first boundary condition. First boundary condition. What is first boundary condition? At x is equal to 0, t is equal to t1. So it means, so t is equal to t1. So in this one, if you apply the first boundary condition, so at x is equal to 0, t is equal to t1. So then c2, we'll get the c2 value. So t1 is equal to c1 into x plus 0 plus c2. So then t1 is equal to c2. Okay, this one. So if you apply the second boundary condition, at x is equal to L, t is equal to t2. Okay, so if you apply the second boundary condition, then t is equal to t2 is equal to c1 into L. In x place, you have to write the L. So because according to second boundary condition, so plus c2. Okay, see here c2, you know that value, c2 is equal to t1 here. Okay, you can substitute the value of c2 in place, so t1 value in the place of c2. So because c t1 is equal to c2, so then t2 is equal to c1 l plus t1. Okay, so from which we can find out the c1 value. So what is c1? C1 is equal to, so t2 minus t1 by l. So we know that c1, this is the c1 value, this one is the c2 value. So if you substitute the c1 and c2 value in general equation, we will get the t value. So this is the general equation. If you apply the c1 and c2 values in general equation, okay, then t is equal to, you know that c1 value, c1 is equal to, this is the c1 value. So t2 minus t1 by L. So apply that into x plus c2. You know that c2 is equal to, this is the t1. You can apply this one. So so this value, or you can rewrite like this one. T is equal to c1 of t1 of, so t1 minus t1 minus t2 by L into x, because t2 is always greater than t1 is always greater than the t2, because so heat transfer takes place from higher temperature to lower temperature. So here also t1 is greater than, so we can write t1 minus, so t1 minus t2 by L into x. So this is the just like equation for the t. So in this way, just like you can find out any temperature at a particular distance, if you know the distance and if you know the initial and final temperature and thickness of that slab, we can find out the temperatures. So this is the formula for the temperature. So next just like we will find the rate of heat transfer Q. So how to find Q? So you know that the Fourier's law, because here heat is transferred through conduction process. Okay, so to explain the conduction phenomena, we know that Fourier's law is there. So according to Fourier's law, Q is equal to minus K A into dT by dx. Okay, so is equal to Q is equal to K A into, so temperature difference, you know that dT. So otherwise, just like you can here. So you know the value of T. So T is equal to T1 minus, so minus bracket of T1 minus T2 by L into X. So if you derivative that one, so dT by dx. dT by dx. Okay. Here. Okay. So dT by dx. Then, so with respect to x, then this value, so T1 value will be 0. So with respect to x means, so T1 minus so T2 by L. So, so we'll get minus T1 minus so T2 by L. So this is the value. If you substitute the dT by dx value in this formula, you know that dT by dx is equal to. So if you substitute that one, so here minus, so here minus will be cancelled, that will be plus. So then T1 minus T2 by L will get. So the finally, so this is the rate of heat transfer formula. So I have to remember that one. So finally, the rate of heat transfer in any slab, in single slab, that is equal to Ka into T1 minus T2 by L. So we can rewrite like this one. So Q is equal to, so temperature difference by, so L by Ka. So L by Ka is simply called as a thermal resistivity, RTH. It means according to the electrical analog, so we can write like this one. So this is the temperature T1, this is the temperature T2, this is the thermal resistivity. This shows the Q, rate of heat transfer. This shows the rate of heat transfer. So rate of heat transfer is uniform. So then you can write like this according to electrical resistivity analog. So Q, this Q is equal to, so temperature difference T1 minus T2 by thermal resistivity. So what is thermal resistivity? So L by K is the thermal resistivity. So in this way, just like you can consider this formula. So either in this way or this way also, okay, for solving the different rate of heat transfer problems in the slabs. Okay. So now we'll see the heat conduction through composite wall. So previously we saw the, so rate of heat transfer or heat conduction through single slab. Now we'll see the heat conduction through a composite walls or composite slabs. If there are many layers of the slabs, what, how the rate of heat transfer will be follow or will be continue. So we'll see this one. So here, just like so rate of heat transfer is uniform at any slab or any so any slab, either one or two, three, or any more number of layers. Okay, so this is the first layer of this slab. The temperature is just like inner temperature is T1, outer temperature is equal to T2. This is the second layer. So inner temperature is equal to T2 and outer temperature is equal to T3. So this is the third layer. So temperature is equal to T3 and outer temperature is equal to T4. So Q is the rate of heat transfer. So Ka is the thermal conductivity of the first slab, and Kb is the thermal conductivity of the slab B. So Kc is the thermal conductivity of the slab C. So we can say A, B, C, three slabs are there, or three layers of the slab are three layers of the walls. Okay, so LA shows the thickness of first layer or first wall. LB shows the thickness of the second wall, and LC shows the thickness of the third wall. Okay, so assuming there is a perfect contact between the layers, so if you, there is the perfect contact, so conduction takes place properly. Okay, so if you can write this rate of heat transfer problem for the in the form of electrical analog. Okay, so rate of heat transfer Q, this is the Q, here also Q is uniform, here also Q is uniform, so here, so lastly Q is uniform. Okay, so temperature will be changes, the first temperature, so it starts from, so T1 to T2 and T3 and T4. Okay, so T1 to first slab, so that is the thermal resistivity of the first slab, and okay, T2, this is the thermal resistivity of the second slab, and T3, thermal resistivity of the third slab. Okay, so okay, you know that thermal resistivity, so that formula is equal to you know that for single slab already discussed in the previous slide, that is the Q is equal to temperature difference T1 minus T2 by L1 by K1A. Okay, so here area is uniform, so because these are the same height, same width, and same thickness, same length also, so area is uniform. So this formula can rewrite like this in the in the flux type. So Q by A, you can write like Q by A also. So for that the thermal resistivity is equal to L1 by K1. Okay, so otherwise you can write directly L1 by K1 A area. Okay, so for this is the first slab. For the second slab, so that is the T2 minus T3. So this is the T2 minus T3 by just like L3 or LB by KB and A. So similarly for the third one, T3 minus T4 by just like LC by KC A area. So this is the thermal resistivity. So LA by KAA, and thermal resistivity of the layer B, that is the LB by KBA. So thermal resistivity of the C, so that is the LC by KCA. Okay, so this is the, so we'll derive the final Q in different composite walls. Okay, so we'll see this one also. So we'll see, first of all, first slab, so that is the, just like for the first slab, rate of heat transfer Q is equal to T1 minus T2 by, so thermal resistivity LA by, so KA into area, so K is the suffix, so that is the LA. Okay, so this is the equation one. Otherwise you can rewrite like this one, so T1 minus so T2 is equal to, so Q into so LA by KA into area. Okay, so similarly for the second slab, that is the Q is equal to, so T2 minus so T3 by LB by KB into area. So we can rewrite like this, T2 minus so T3 is equal to Q into, so LB by KB into area. Okay, so this is the equation two, this one is the equation one. Okay, so for the second slab, third slab, so Q is equal to, so T3 minus so T4 by, so LC by KC into area. So you can rewrite like this one. So this is the T3 minus T4 is equal to, so Q into LC by KC into area. So this is the equation 3. If you add equation 1, 2, 3, so equation 1 plus equation 2 plus equation 3. Okay, then the so right side is equal to, so T1 minus so T2 plus T2 minus so T3, so plus T4 plus T3 minus so T3 minus T4. So this is the left side. So in right side is equal to Q is common. So Q, if you take common Q and A area also common, then LA by KA plus LB by KB plus LC by KC. Okay. So here in right side, so minus T2 plus T2 minus T3 plus T3 will be cancelled. So finally we'll get to, so T1 minus initial temperature minus final temperature. So T1 minus T2 is equal to, we'll get this one. So finally you can write like this one. So T1 minus so T2 is equal to, so Q by L into L1 by LA by KA plus LB by KB, so plus LC by KC. Okay, so then Q by L is equal to T1 minus so T4, not T2, this is the T4, so final temperature. Okay, so T4 divided by so LA by KA, so plus LB by KB plus LC by KC. So this is the formula. Otherwise you can rewrite like this one. So this is not L, this is the area. Okay, so then Q is equal to, so T1 minus so T4 by so LA by so KA into area plus LB by KB into area plus LC by KC into area. So these are the thermal resistivities. Okay, so this is the RTHA with respect to A slab, thermal resistivity with respect to B slab, thermal resistivity with respect to C slab. So we can write like this one. So this is the this is equal to, so T1 minus T4 initial temperature minus final temperature by sigma r. So sigma r is the, so all thermal resistivities, it means RTHA and RTHB and RTHC. So in this way we can find out the rate of heat transfer. So in any number of slabs, if the number of slabs will be increases, then thermal resistivities also increases. So just like LA by K, A area, LB by KB, LC by KC. And if the one more, if there is a one more layer, then LD by KD. So if you take, if you source the number of layers 1, 2, 3, then L1 by K1, L2 by K2, L3 by K3. Okay. So this is the formula. So we'll see some small numerical here, just like we can observe here. So the inner surface of a plain brick wall is 60 degrees and the outer surface temperature also given. So that is the just like 35. So inner 60 degrees and outer temperature is equal to 35 degrees. Okay, so calculate the rate of heat transfer per meter square. So area 1 meter square, it means so you have to find out the Q by A area. So you have to find out the heat flux and wall thickness also given, that is L is equal to 220 mm. So 220 mm, it should be converted into meters. Then thermal conductivity also given, that is the 0.51. watt per meter degree centigrade. So then you know the formula Q by A is equal to, so temperature T1 minus so Q by A is equal to, so T1 minus so T2 by so L1 by K1, or there is only one slab, so L by K you can take. Okay, so not this formula. Okay, so you can write like this one, or KL into K into T1 minus T2 by L, you can write like this one also. So this is the formula. Otherwise I want to repeat this one, just like the final formula is equal to Q into K into T1 minus T2 by L. This is the formula. So we required Q by A. So then this is the K into T1 minus T2 by L. Or we can write like this one, T1 minus T2 by L by K. So according to electrical analog formula. So you know the formula. So T1 is equal to, you know that T1 is equal to 60 minus T2 is equal to 35. So divided by, so L is equal to 220 mm, it means 0.22 by K. K is equal to 0.51. Then we will get the final value if you solve this one. Okay, so in this way, just like we can solve different numericals, just one model has been given here. Okay, so let's see. So there is a one more just like numerical is given. So an aluminum plate, thermal conductivity of the aluminum plate is 215 watt per meter degree centigrade. It is heated to 300 degree centigrade. If the heat flux is given, so that is heat flux nothing but Q by A. So Q by A is equal to 8.6 so megawatts per meter square. So how hot is the other phase? So we have to find out the temperature. One temperature T1 is given, so that is the 300 degree centigrade. We have to find out the T2. So we have to find out the T2 value. Is the metal thickness also given, that is the L is equal to 5 mm. So we have to convert into meters, 0.005 meters. Okay. So then you know the formula Q by A is equal to K into T1 minus T2 by L. So otherwise you can write like this one, so K by L, L by K. So you know the Q by A value and L value and K value and T1 value. You have to find out the T2. So then T2 is equal to T1 minus Q by A into L by K. So if you substitute the value, so 300 minus so Q by A, what is Q by A? 8.6 into mega watt per meter square, then 10 cube into L. L is equal to, we can write like the 5 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So by K, K is equal to thermal conductivity. So 215. Okay. So this one will be cancelled. If you solve that one, then we will get to answer. Okay. So in this way, just like we can solve different numericals. So, okay. So this is the answer you can find out. So one more thing I want to explain about it. So up to here we saw the only conduction mode, only the rate of heat transfer through conduction in different slabs or different layers of the slabs. If you consider the convection also, just like you know the process of convection. So convection takes place in fluid to solid and solid to fluid or fluid to fluid also. So here just like this is the inner air. So inner air temperature is equal to THF. Okay. So next to heat is transferred from inner hot air to just like inner surface of the wall. So that is the temperature is equal to T1. Then temperature is just like then heat is transferred to temperature T2. So T2 is equal to outer surface temperature, that is the T2. Okay. Then heat transfer takes place from outer surface temperature to just like atmospheric air. So that is the ambient temperature. TCF is the so cool fluid temperature. So finally, heat transfer from hot fluid to cold fluid. In between, there is a one slab. Okay. So here, so hot fluid to inner surface of the slab. So that is heat transfer takes place by here convection process. Okay. So in this slab, that is the conduction process. So from outer surface of the slab to cold fluid. So heat is transferred from solid to fluid. So here also convection. So finally convection plus conduction plus convection. Okay. So you know the formula. So for that, we can write the just like electrical analog formula, that is the THF. So 1/ just like you know the formula, convection formula is equal to, so for convection Q is equal to HA into T1 minus T2. Okay. So H is the rate of heat transfer. Okay. So we can rewrite like this one, T1 minus T2 by 1/HA. So 1/HA is the thermal conductivity. So here HF, hot fluid, rate of heat transfer of the hot fluid, okay, into area, plus T1 minus T2, here conduction, so that is the L/K, yeah? So here convection, so that is the 1/HCF, so cold fluid, rate of heat transfer for the cold fluid into area. So in this way, just like we can solve the different numericals, okay. So here, if you take the just like first one, so heat transfer from hot fluid to just like inner surface of the slab, so that is the section one. So this is the, so in inner surface of the slab to outer surface of the slab, that is the conduction two. So next two stage, heat transfer from the outer surface to just like cold fluid, so that is the convection stage three. So we will get to three equations. That is the first equation according to convection. So the Q is equal to H, hot fluid heat transfer coefficient into area into THF, hot fluid temperature minus T1, so inner temperature of the slab. So that is equation one. So next to Q is equal to minus KA T1 minus T2 by L. That is the just like equation two. This is the this one is the convection, this is the conduction. So this one is the just like again convection. Okay. So hot fluid just like outer surface temperature of the slab to just like ambient temperature or atmospheric temperature, TCF. So HCF is the hot fluid heat transfer coefficient of cold fluid. So then thermal resistivity is THF. So equation, if you can rewrite like this one, is HF. THF minus T1 is equal to Q by HF area. So T1 minus T2 is equal to Q by KA by L. T2 minus TCF is equal to Q by L. If you add this one, if you add all this one, just like you will get similarly. So that is the T1 minus THF, T hot fluid minus T cold fluid. So initial temperature minus final temperature by, so Q by thermal resistivity with respect to the convection. So that is the 1/HF plus area. So KA by L, that is the conduction. Next to, so this is the 1/HCF into area. Here also area. So we will get this formula. So in this way, just like we can solve different numericals which are including the conduction phenomena and convection phenomena. So thank you for watching this class. We'll see remaining portion next class. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.